Therefore, the Lord Himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel.
Help me, Lord, to mirror you. And I pray that From the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. This is how Jesus Christ was born. Mary, his mother, was engaged to Joseph. But before they came together as husband and wife, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, made plans to divorce her in all secrecy, for he was an upright man and did not want to disgrace her. While he was pondering over this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, descendant of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. She has conceived by the Holy Spirit and will bear a son whom you shall call Jesus. For he will save his people for their sins." And all this happened in order to fulfill what the Lord has said through the prophet. "The virgin conceived and bare a son, and he will be called Emmanuel," which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had told him to do, and he took Mary as his wife. But he had not had marital relationship with her until she gave birth to a son and called his name Jesus.
Thank you. while she was working, angels appeared to her, and an angel said, God is pleased with you and has chosen and blessed you. You will give birth to a baby boy who is the Son of God, and whom you should call Jesus. Mary was worried, but she trusted God. Joseph was a loving and helpful person. The angels also appeared to Joseph in his dream and told him God's plan. Joseph was also a poor and hard-working carpenter who was engaged to Mary. Soon he was married to Mary, and the good news spread everywhere about the king to be born. The king of that time, King Herod, on hearing this good news, he called and ordered his soldiers to go out and kill all the newborn babies. The soldiers did exactly what their king told them to do. Joseph and Mary were scared, and quietly they fled from Nazareth to Bethlehem. Mary came to Bethlehem sitting on a donkey. They were tired, but could not find a place for shelter. One person felt sorry for them and offered his stable for the night. That night, in the stable, Mary gave birth to the King of Kings and named him Jesus. The shepherds who were looking after their sheep on that cold wintry night saw a star shining in the sky, and suddenly the angels appeared to them. The shepherds got afraid, and an angel told them, "Do not be afraid," and she gave them the good news of the newborn king and also told them to follow that bright shining star to the manger. The shepherds followed the star and reached the manger. On the other side, the three wise men also saw this bright star and knew something good has happened. They followed the star to the manger, bringing gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. So, my dear friends, this is why we all celebrate Christmas. Christmas is the time of love, joy, and hope, of sharing and one another. So we kindle lights. Wish you all merry.
My dear students and members of the staff, there was an elderly lady who was habituated to give alms to a particular poor man sitting outside the church. One Sunday, after the service, when she opened her purse to help that man, she found her purse empty. Feeling sad, the lady told the poor, "Brother, I don't have anything to give you today." However, the man with happiness said, "Today you have given me the best gift. You have touched me and called me brother." Yes, Christmas is nothing but the celebration of God becoming man in the form of Jesus to touch the human beings. He came down to touch the humanity and to lift them up from the clutches of evil. As he grew into an adult person, he went about curing the physically handicapped, healing the sick, restoring the dead to life, and preaching the message of love, peace, and justice. His heart was moved with compassion and love, and he reached out to every person who was in need. Perhaps this Christmas may be different from the other years, as there is a void created by loss of connection with the other people. Yet this Christmas invites us to touch human beings in our own simple ways. There are people around us who are suppressed, oppressed, and depressed. Can I give a listening ear to them? There are people walking in darkness of sin and evil tendencies. Can I become a guiding star for them? There are people who are hungry and thirsty and homeless. Can I extend my generous hand towards them? There are people sick and facing other problems. Can I become a source of consolation and comfort for them? This year, as you celebrate Christmas, each of you decide to touch the life of people or some homes, trying to bring smile in the face of someone. Let this Christmas become a source of blessing from God above. May Jesus bless you and your family with peace, joy, and happiness. May He bless and grant success in every endeavor that you are going to undertake. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year 2021. Stay safe, stay blessed, enjoy your holidays.
many reindeer games. And one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you ride my sleigh tonight?
Then all the reindeer loved him.
Loved him. Go down in history.
Hello everyone. I am sure you must have enjoyed today's Christmas program. I am very thankful for giving me the opportunity to give the vote of thanks today. Being grateful is more precious than any other valuable gift on the earth. First and foremost, I would like to thank Almighty God for bringing us all as one family to celebrate the birth of Jesus. A big thanks to our principal, Sister Flora, who keeps on encouraging us and providing us with lots of opportunity to be active. We are grateful to our manager, Sister Alice, who has given a beautiful Christmas message. We would like to acknowledge our Vice Principal, Sister Sukreen, who always helps and encourages us to walk another mile with a smile. We also want to express our gratitude towards our Headmistress, Sister Alinda, who is always at our side. An event cannot happen overnight. There are many who have worked behind the scenes. We are immensely thankful for all the teachers who have taken lots of efforts to make this program a success. A special thanks to the coordinator, Teacher Raji, to plan, practice and see its completion. And also Teacher Rupa, who has done the work of videography and editing. We want to thank all the teachers and Sir Suhas for their generosity and readiness to help out for the backdrop. A special mention for Sir Chetan for his carol practices, carol singing and the music. We thank all the teachers who were the in charge of prayer, skit, nativity scene and dance. We appreciate all the efforts you have taken for the program and practice. I am short of words to thank our catechism, budding rock stars and others who have made this program joyful with their performance. A sincere thanks to all the non-teaching staff led by Sister Dania, who were always ready to help and provide us with all the requirements. We thank you for your selfless service with great smile. May this season of Christmas bring joy, hope and happiness for everyone. Wish you a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year 2021 in advance. Thank you.
Ram pam pam.
It's coming up for the